हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट ए न्यू टॉपिक, यूज ऑफ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. यूज ऑफ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, दिस टॉपिक फ्रॉम चैप्टर 4 ऑफ क्लास 10th इन सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री. लेट्स ओपन योर बुक एंड कम ऑन द पेज नंबर 71. नाउ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, NaOH. सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रिएजेंट इन द क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस. It is mainly used in the precipitation of insoluble hydroxide from metallic salt solution. So it is mainly used for the precipitation of insoluble hydroxide from metallic salt solution. That means when metallic salt solution react with sodium hydroxide, then form an insoluble hydroxide of respective metals. When sodium hydroxide is added dropwise to a metallic salt solution, the hydroxide of the metal get precipitated. That means it form an insoluble substance, and the formation and color of this precipitate help a lot in the identification of metal ions. So by getting the insoluble precipitate of a particular metal hydroxide, we can identify, and it help to identification of a particular metal. If excess amount of sodium hydroxide added in the when added in the solutions, then it form a soluble complex salt, and soluble complex salt also have a particular color, and that help in the identification of the metal ions. So here we go through the details about their use and the action of sodium hydroxide on certain metal salt solution. So the new topic, action of sodium hydroxide on certain salt solutions. The action of sodium hydroxide on certain metallic salt solution is here discussed. First, the iron, the ferrous salt Fe2+ salt. When FeSO4 react with ferrous salt, react with NaOH, that ferrous salt has pale green solution. When react with the NaOH also here act as a reagent, then it forms the ferric hydroxide, and ferric hydroxide it is precipitate out, and the color of this ferric hydroxide is dirty green gelatinous. So the presence of the appearance of dirty green gelatinous precipitate during the reaction, when a salt solution react with NaOH, it means that the given salt solution is ferrous salt. This precipitate remain insoluble on further adding of sodium hydroxide drop by drop in excess. Now next, ferric salt, identification of the ferric salt, and what is the action of NaOH on ferric salt. FeCl3 ferric chloride, it have a yellow solution. When react with the NaOH, they form the ferric hydroxide. The ferric hydroxide which is precipitated out in the solution, and the color of this ferric hydroxide precipitate is reddish brown. So when a salt solution react with NaOH and form a reddish brown precipitate, that means the given salt solution is the ferric salt. Next example, ferric sulfate, which has also yellow solution, when react with NaOH form the ferric hydroxide, and ferric hydroxide precipitate out in the solution, and the color of this precipitate ferric hydroxide is reddish brown. That means the given solution is a ferric salt solution. This precipitate, ferric hydroxide precipitate, also remain insoluble on further adding of sodium hydroxide in excess. Now next examples, आइडेंटिफिकेशन और एक्शन ऑफ NaOH ऑन कपर साल्ट सोल्यूशन कपर टू प्लस. वेन कपर सल्फेट रिएक्ट विथ NaOH कपर सल्फेट, द कपर सल्फेट हैज ए ब्लू कलर. वेन रिएक्ट विथ NaOH इट फॉर्म द कपर हाइड्रोक्साइड क्यूप्रिक हाइड्रोक्साइड, इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द क्यूप्रिक हाइड्रोक्साइड. क्यूप्रिक हाइड्रोक्साइड विच इज प्रेसिपिटेट आउट इन द सोल्यूशन एंड देयर कलर इज पेल ब्लू कलर. सो द पेल ब्लू कलर वेन अपीयर दैट मीन्स द गिवेन साल्ट इज कपर साल्ट. दिस प्रेसिपिटेट रिमेन ऑल्सो इनसोल्यूबल ऑन फर्दर एडिशन ऑफ एक्सेस अमाउंट ऑफ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. नाउ नेक्स्ट द आइडेंटिफिकेशन और एक्शन ऑफ NaOH विथ जिंक साल्ट Zn2+. When zinc sulfate ZnSO4, zinc sulfate solution, it is a colorless solution. When react with the NaOH, it forms the zinc hydroxide, and zinc hydroxide is precipitated out in the solution, and the color of the zinc hydroxide is white gelatinous precipitate. So when the white gelatinous precipitate find out during the reaction with NaOH of any salt, then given salt is zinc salt. On further addition of zinc hydroxide drop by drop in excess, the gelatinous white solution which is present in the solutions will dissolve due to the formation of soluble complex sodium zincate. So if we add the excess amount of NaOH in the zinc salt solution, then zinc hydroxide further react with NaOH and form a soluble sodium zincate, and the color of the sodium zincate is colorless, it's no any colors. Sodium zincate Na2ZnO2. Now come on the page number 72. Come on the page number 72. Page number 72. For next examples, when NaOH react with the lead salt, such as lead nitrate PbNO3 twice, when react with the NaOH, lead nitrate has the colorless solutions. When react with the NaOH, it forms the lead hydroxide. Lead hydroxide has the white precipitate. Now, on further addition of sodium hydroxide solution in excess, the precipitate of lead hydroxide, this lead hydroxide, dissolve and form a soluble complex salt, that is sodium plumbite. When we add the excess amount of the NaOH in lead salt, then the formed lead hydroxide precipitate react with NaOH, excess NaOH, and formed a soluble sodium plumbite salt. The color of sodium plumbite is colorless, there is no any colors. So both zinc hydroxide and lead hydroxide are amphoteric, so they react with alkali forming salt and water. Now next example, calcium salt. The action of NaOH on the calcium salt. The calcium salt such as calcium nitrate, which is the solution of calcium nitrate, is a colorless. When react with the NaOH solution, then it forms the calcium hydroxide, the white precipitate of the calcium hydroxide in the solutions. So the appearance of the white precipitate when any salt react with the NaOH, that means the given salt is the calcium salt. The precipitate which formed during the reaction, that is calcium hydroxide, is sparingly soluble in excess of sodium hydroxide. So this is all about the uses and action of the sodium hydroxide.